In this video, I'm going to show you how to read text entries in Unity. Specifically, what I want to achieve is to have an input field on the screen that allows the user to enter a text and send that information to a script and store it in a variable. Let's begin. Right-click on the hierarchy, UI, and then select Input Field. I will configure a little bit the canvas. Here, this canvas scaler component changed this parameter to scale with screen size and set the reference resolution to 1920 by 1080, which is the resolution I'm currently using. Then adjust a little bit the input field on the screen, change the size of the element, the font size, center it vertically. Now when entering the play mode, we see that the field can already be used to enter text. Now we need to send the information we write in this field to a script. For that, we select the input field and here scroll down and see this component that is called input field. Here below, we see that there are two events. One is on value changed, an event that is executed with a string type parameter, and the other event is on end edit. These events can be used to execute functions within scripts. We will use the on end edit event. Here we have to drag a game object that has a script with a function to execute. For that, first of all, we will create the script. Right click, create C# script, and I name it read input. Under update, we are going to define the following function: public void read string input, and make it receive a string as parameter, like a string called s. Another thing we are going to do is to define a string variable within the script. Let's name it input. This will allow us to store the text entry. Then inside the function, we assign this string s to the variable. Input equals s. And I will also print this string in the console. This way we will make sure that it's working. Now we need to assign this script to a game object in the hierarchy. It could be to any game object. In my case, I will simply assign it to the camera. Select the input field. In the onEndEdit event, we have to drag the camera game object because it has the script. And using this drop-down menu, I select the proper function within the readInput script. In this case, is here, within this dynamic string category, read string input. This is the function that we want to execute. If it doesn't appear in this list for you, you probably define it as private or you didn't specify the visibility. This has to be public. So now, when we enter the play mode, write the text and hit enter, we see that the message is displayed in the console. This means the text is stored in the input variable. On end edit will also be executed when we write an entry, for example this entry, and we click somewhere else on the screen. Note that here also appears the console message, and it's telling us that now the input variable has this data assigned. On end edit also runs when we are entering a text and press the escape key. Doing that, we return to the previous string, but the on end edit function is executed. Notice that here the console is telling us that. That's all I wanted to show you, hope you find it useful, and see you next time.